Good day, Grade 7! Welcome to Arts Class Lesson 2. To jumpstart the lesson, let us define first the following terminologies. Arts is a diverse range of human activities involving the creation of visual, auditory, or performing artifacts, which express the creator's imagination, conceptual ideas, or technical skill intended to be appreciated primarily for their beauty or emotional power. Crafts is an activity involving skills in making things by hand. Then, arts and crafts describe a wide variety of activities involving making things with one's own hands. The importance of unlocking those important terminologies is connected with our lesson in First Quarter Arts 7, The Arts and Crafts of Luzon, Highlands and Lowlands. Let us identify the content standard. Performance standard. And most essential learning competencies. These are some types of arts and crafts: textile, pottery, basketry, tattooing, sculpture, accessories, paper craft, architecture, handicrafts, wood carving, and body ornamentation. For the review, identify the pictures in the next slides. Name the types of arts and crafts. You only have 5 seconds to answer. Ready! The answer is architecture. The answer is basketry. The answer is paper craft. The answer is wood carving. Moving on, Lesson 2 is all about the arts and crafts of Cagayan Valley, Central Luzon, Calabarzon, Bicol Region. You will become familiar with the different designs, motifs, and history of their attire, fabrics, crafts, and accessories used by the people in their region. To begin with Lesson 2, you will get to know the different arts and crafts of Cagayan Valley, particularly Batanes, Isabela, and Nueva Vizcaya. The Ivatan are the people living in the Batanes group of islands. Their houses have unique architectural forms made up of limestone walls, reed, and kugon roofs. Bakul is a headgear used by the Ivatan women to protect them from the heat of the sun and from the rain. On the other hand, men wear suot, a rain cape made from fronds that covers the upper part of the body down from the neck. This special clothing is made up of a woven fibers of the buyabuy palm, a plant similar to coconut. Isabela is one of the largest provinces in the Philippines, located in Cagayan Valley region. Tamuani Church is a Roman Catholic parish church of San Matias Apostol, built in 1783. Nueva Vizcaya is located near Ifugao, Benguet, and Quirino. The Gadangs of Nueva Vizcaya are known for their craft and textiles. One of the clothes they make is the bakwat, a belt used by mothers after giving birth. This cloth is usually adorned on the central portion with white beads as accent embellished in patterns that represent rivers and mountains. Another part of Lesson 2 that you will get to know are different arts and crafts of Central Luzon, including Bulacan, Pampanga, Zambales, Nueva Ecija, and Bataan. In Bulacan, singkaban is the local term for bamboo arcs designed with kayas or wood shaving. These are used as decorative arcs that adorn the entrance of a barangay or town during fiestas and other grand celebrations. The women cut intricately designed pastillas wrappers adorned with different linear and curvilinear and geometric design that depicts local florals and scenes of everyday rural life. Mikawayan Bulacan is known for its jewelry industry. Craftsmen fashion trinkets from precious metals such as gold and silver, and precious and semi-precious stones, pearls, and diamonds. Pampanga is known for its giant lanterns or parol. Its special feature is dancing lights in several shades and colors that forms intricate geometric patterns. Spanish Gate is one of the historic landmarks located in Olongapo City, Zambales. It was built in 1885. Aside from being used as an entrance and exit to the naval station, it was also used as a jail during the Spanish and American occupation. The San Andres Apostol Parish Church of Masinloc, Zambales is known for the use of coral stone instead of adobe. It was founded by the Agustinian Recollects in 1607. The belfry is composed of circular columns topped by a lantern and a cross. The Parish of the Three Kings in Gapan City is one of the biggest and the oldest churches in Nueva Ecija. This Roman Catholic church was built in 1800s. This is an example of Western architecture. Abucay Church or the St. Dominic de Guzman Parish Church, established in 1587. It has a 5-layer bell tower ornamented with semicircular arch windows. It is an example of Renaissance architecture. Next are the arts and crafts of Calabar Zone, particularly the following provinces: Laguna, Rizal Province, Batangas, and Quezon. Paete, one of the towns in Laguna, is famous for its wood carving and is considered as the wood carving capital of the Philippines. The local term for carving is ukit. Paete carvers usually produce wooden religious images and wood panels with decorative floral patterns and florid geometric designs. Angono in Rizal Province is considered as the art capital of the Philippines because of the town's rich artistic expression that includes music, painting, sculpture, and folk arts. The town is also known for its gigantes, or big papier-mâché figures of humans that represent farmers and fishermen. Taal, Batangas is famous for producing embroidered piña fabric used for barong, wedding gowns, and formal attires. The borda, called calado, is painstakingly made by three groups of people: designer, embroider, and cutter. Batangas is the balisong capital of the Philippines. Balisong is also known as butterfly knife. It can be folded closed like a fan. The town Lukban is famous for the Pahias Festival, celebrated in the 15th day of May to honor the patron saint of farmers, San Isidro Labrador. The houses are decorated with kipping that is made from ground glutinous rice. The last one for lesson 2 is the arts and crafts of Bicol Region. Arts and crafts that are made from abaca and raffia fibers are basket, bags, slippers, coin purse. The abundance of these natural fibers in the region allowed the Bicolanos to excel in weaving. Here are the references that I have used in doing my presentation. Credits to the owners of different photos used per slides. Sources are underneath each pictures. This is your art teacher for today, Mrs. Cynthia Soledad S. Aspe. Thank you for watching my video lesson. Before I end, let me share with you the quote that I've got from www.zibit.com. Something handmade is much more meaningful. Have a nice day!